meaning of us being here together for common purpose. In this case, a great celebration. Here in Noongar country, we cover the southwest corner of this state, going north almost to Geraldton, through the wheat belt to the start of the goldfields, east to around Esperance, and everything from that line to the coast and beyond. We have 14 clans, and the clan for the Noongar in Noongar country for the metropolitan area is called the Whadjuk clan. So I pay special respect and regard to people of the Whadjuk clan. We have six seasons rather than four, and right now we're at the beginning of the season that we call Canberrang. It's before it heats up too much over Christmas and the New Year. Some of you, as you entered the gate, would have had the opportunity to walk through smoke. We have a smoking ceremony that is important in terms of cleansing and welcoming you. It means that you will be safe not only for these proceedings, but also on your drive home.
In the annals of Western Australia's Army history, the re-raising of an iconic Australian Army regiment. Today, we are fortunate to witness the re-raising of 10th Light Horse as a regiment. The first 10th Light Horse regiment being raised 107 years ago in October 1914 as part of the Imperial Force from Australia, the AIF, for service overseas in World War I, where it served with great distinction in Turkey during the Gallipoli campaign and in the desert campaigns in Sinai, Palestine and Syria. A Victoria Cross, the highest recognition for supreme valour that the then British Empire could bestow, was awarded to Lieutenant Hugo Throssell of the 10th Light Horse Regiment for his personal bravery and leadership in command of a post that was hotly contested over many hours at the Battle of Hill 60 on Gallipoli. This remains the only Victoria Cross to a soldier in an Australian Light Horse unit, and indeed the only Victoria Cross within the Royal Australian Army. Thank you.
Fatherhood.
The adjutant of 10th Light Horse Regiment, Captain Philip Zee, will now take the parade from the RSM. He will then order march on the officers. Jerusalem, Jordan is salt, Megiddo, Sharon, and Damascus. Infantry units have two larger flags known as the Queen's and Regimental Colours. Colours were used in the very early days of warfare as a rallying point for the individual units and are revered. The last time colours were carried into battle was in 1881 during the First World War. The guidon parade today was presented to the unit by the then governor.